I think this is the right spot. I don't know. I kind of feel nostalgic for the way I used to start videos. I used to always look here for some reason. I have no idea why. Hello, this is RedMcNed, and welcome back to the saga. And I'm glad to that it's back. To be that it's back. Because I had some technical difficulties last week. Technically, I was the difficulty, so I guess that qualifies. I was sick. I got some good nasal infection, so that's a lot of fun. If you haven't had it, good job, good for you. It's probably more fun than any Disneyland I've ever been to. It's a real treat. You haven't lived until you've had a nasal infection. Luckily, I'm feeling a lot better. If you can't tell, good. I mean, not if I'm better, you can't tell. But if like you can't tell by my voice, I think my voice is still a little bit messed up. It was really messed up a week ago, and I had like no time to do anything. So here we are. So today on the saga, it's kind of a moving day. Things are gonna be changing around here. Things are gonna be moved, actually, and it's gonna be kind of strange. Here, let me show you. This place has been with me since the early beginning. Not just the beginning, the early beginning. And this has been where I did all the enchants, and my resources have kept them in there as I've collected them. I've done pretty good for myself, and a little brewing stand for bottled water. I don't do any other substances. I don't know what you're talking about. And there's some smelting-lery. But I have an axe, and it needs to find things to smash. You see, this place is not going to stay this place anymore. It needs to move. I've yet to do the interior in a lot of these places, and I feel like it's really essential to get. I know that these are serving a purpose, but I need to make room. Because I wanted to start doing interiors. Interiors have always been a tough thing for me. And they're going to keep being a tough thing until I do them. So it's going to be kind of weird moving these things. I've gotten really used to where they are. The weirdest part for me is probably going to be moving this place. This is the storage for myself, if you didn't know. Like, cobble on this side. Smooth on this one. These aren't awful. They're not that crazy. But I'm pretty close to crazy because they're about half close. Full. I mean, they're half full. That's what I meant to say. This is where I've been doing all the smelts and just keeping things, Whenever I got something that needs to be stored, it goes in here. But something, every so often, I get reminded that I put my storage unit in the nether, and that's not really a smart place to put it. For the fact that every time I expand a little bit, sometimes I've like, oh, I there comes lava, or the fact that I hear like two or three ghasts sometimes when I'm just hanging out in here. Also, if I put down my ender chest, I need to make sure that I mine toward another chest. Otherwise, I could be like, whoops, and then I have a huge hole. And well, this is all over an abyss. That's the other part. This is all going to the sky base. All these things. But I'm not done up here yet. There's something else that I must do. I must take care of something. Something that's been a plague to this land, much greater than myself. This needs to not be here anymore. It was my first house. No, it wasn't. That was my first attempt at a better house than. I still have this one over there. Oh. I built this one at the end of episode 3, right before I needed to get some advice on how to actually build. For some reason, I kept it here this whole time. It's almost 40 episodes, and it's still here. So, ceremoniously, unceremoniously, it's gotta go. So, Here goes. I want to show every second of this because this is what I've been putting off for some reason. You know, I thought that I would actually have some sort of sentimental reaction to this. I actually don't. That's actually really funny. I actually... Yep, this is... That's it. That's gone. I already don't miss it. Ah, good riddance. And you know what? Let's make this look a little better. You know, let's get rid of all this. What is this even? We don't even have to even, you know? All right, maybe I can help this out. Two at a time there. Three. And three. Alright, it's gone. It's gone. On the other hand, I actually have incredible nostalgia for this place. Wow, it feels weird not having all these, I have the two furnaces, the bed, crafting table. I'm barely listing them off, because there's barely any room here. And the revolutionary window, remember that? Yeah, you could open it. It was a good window. That's where the farm was. Wow, I didn't realize this was going to be a nostalgia time, but maybe I did actually, maybe... Maybe that's what moving does. It makes you nostalgic. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move everything. And I'm just going to... It's going to take a while. Moving a storage unit takes a while. Just like moving in real life takes a while. So I'm going to cut back when that's done. That seriously took so long. Like, there's no fast way to do it either. Like, if you have double chests full of things, this helps, the center chest, but, oh man. If you can help it, make sure that if you're going to make a big storage area, it's a place that you can just keep it for a long time. Don't choose the nether, unless you're really sure. You probably just, yeah, just don't choose the nether. So yeah, I got the boxes out of here. I left these ones in here because they're just way too useful. Like, the sheep are right over there. I use them a lot. Like, for wool. I use them for wool. This place, though. This is almost creepy. How much is actually missing without this stuff? Like, it feels like its soul was ripped out. It's kind of... So it's weird to see this stuff's gone, but... It's not really gone, it's just been moved to the secret sky base, so no worries. So here at the sky base, things, they are gonna be and are changing. I've been a little busy over there, getting a mass food farm going. I'll explain that later. But over here, on this side, so you see them, I'm keeping with the theme of just like a bunch of little floating kind of farms around this big floating farm. It's just all floating, you know, sky theme. This is what I came up with for a replacement for the other, both the storage area and for the enchanting area. Forgive the rain, it doesn't know better. But I put all the these here, the stoves, and I got the chests over here. And this lovely enchanting area here. I put little corners, little towers of wood here instead of libraries, just because, you know, I kind of like the setup here. It's like a glove that opens this way into all this. This is something that might require some explanation. This is actually where I would break ores. Now, originally, I was going to keep with the theme of having Stone. Let's see, where is it? Stone everything. But you'll notice that I have wood floors and wood rails. That's because if you're mining around, mining ores with a big pick, and you're in the sky, you're gonna accidentally mine some floor once in a while. And that's not good. So basically this is my, This is my strategy for getting through the ores that I collect. Like, let's say I still touch them, bring them home. I can just put them down on this runway. It comfortably seats 2 stacks of ore. I bet if you really squeeze it in, it'd be 3. But the basically what this is there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is 8 wide. With railings on the 8th and the 1st. And there's a torch. Then, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the 5th one, another torch. There's 9 torches total in length. And with that dimensions... with that dimensions, we can be unstoppable. And take care of quite a few ores at once. I'm gonna get the fortune over here. So I tested this out to see if stuff flies over the railing. It does not. And I can just, you know, have fun. And if I accidentally hit the ground, look at that. It takes forever. So either I'm really not paying attention and I deserve any sort of horrible outcome at that point. But for the most part, this is pretty solid. Like, these keeps everything in. I don't back off while I'm placing them because there's railings everywhere. Except for there, but you know, if I'm placing them, I go through here, it's like, oh, I better notice. And there's railings in here too, just in case. Safety first. A fabulous way to get levels. Unless, of course, you have a, I'm actually really happy, though, that this is here, because that means that all of the things that give me experience, pretty much, are all here. Like, if I get a bunch from there, I can come here, instead of having to go into the village, finding the blacksmith, and said it's all here. And I like it to keep it that way. So now that we talked about that, we can talk about this. Another addition to the family. Just birthed this week, so we're real excited. This is a nice little platform. It's 11 deep, and I'm pretty sure it's 9 wide. With some hoppers and a chest over here. There's all the supplies. I was wondering where they were. They make a bunch of storage here. That'll house all of the food that we'll ever want and ever need. And how this is going to be is I built half of it. So that's actually how it is, not how it's going to be. This is what it should look like. I put the food in rows because it actually does grow faster, apparently. So I... Than not putting it in rows, which is kind of strange. But you see over here, there's a little dam sort of thing. So this goes, each of these are 7 in length, so that a source block gets made here, and then it flows 7, and that's just enough to reach over this, go down. This is 7 more, and it keeps doing the 7s. Until it gets to here. This is actually 8. This is 8 across here. Because I don't want the water to flow off this. So what this is here is a bunch of hoppers that feed this way. You can kind of see on the bottoms here. They all the way into this chest. So half of it is this chest. The other half is going to be another chest. And I believe, yeah, I've got 2 trap chests here because it needs to, in order for this to work, it has to be like this. Otherwise, they won't be next to each other. Let's see, other things to know about. This dimension is 8 across. The reason is that if you put water here, it'll hydrate 4 in this direction. And I need one over here to hydrate 4 in this direction. Basically, I put it in the centermost as most as I could so that it'll reach this way, because this will actually hydrate even this over here. Eventually, that'll be wet because there's it reaches four in every direction, and this is a 4x4 here. So see up there, why would I? And why would I lie to you? What point is there? So yeah, this is going all the way up. These torches are also important, and so is this. This is so that I can gracefully come down if I need to. If I go down from as much as a block up, I could actually lose that square. To stay, it immediately looks like this, and the food goes away. There's a massive dust bowl, and I think all my stuff corrupts. It's really bad. Don't let that happen. These torches are set up so that there's no spots that don't get light. Basically, I found that if I put them on the wall, there's two in, and then three this way. It's actually enough combined with this to get the furthest away squares, which is our right here. So if you could actually count it out too. So let's see. Let's go one, two, counting where the light squares are. Three, four, five. If it was seven away, it would be spawnable at night for bad things. So this should be spawn proof. So this is what a cross section of the ground looks like. I went ahead and kept this just in case. There's the seven in length here. This is also seven. I went ahead and put an eighth one on the end so I could build up just for consistent. I know that no one's gonna see it, but I always like to have, if I'm in the sky, for instance, a layer of something that's not dirt between me and a horrible fate. I think it's just water down there, actually, so it's not that horrible. But it's pretty horrible because you have to climb a ladder forever. That's almost akin to death. That's almost there. Looking at you, snake eater. I feel it's important to walk through a little bit of this just for showing. So each of these sides takes 17 hoppers, so that's a grand total of 34. And I just kind of shift click them into each other, and this makes a nice hopper line. From here, I build this up two layers just so that I make sure everything's gonna fall in there. Nothing's gonna eke out, you know. Actually, I'm gonna give this a little bit of a side here too. It's basically gonna look like the other side. So that means something like that. For these, it's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then it's gonna have to be divided. Otherwise, bad. See, I'm gonna go in four spots. And that's where the water is going down. So that's gonna keep it. Give it a nice little backboard there. There's gonna be one there. And there's always gonna be one on the other side. And I think besides this, just so I have a spot to jump onto, get it to two, a double high wall as fast as possible. Stumbled into an interesting accent there. The reason it's too high here is because stuff likes to get onto the one high wall. Build that up for aesthetics. And yeah, about there. Throw a torch on that, because it looks like it's beckoning for it a little bit. I went ahead and made what I think is the best investment that I've ever made. It's a lovely pick. It's a hoe with dollar signs. While I'm here, I might as well build this up. This is the other side of the staircase. I only brought this out like four, I think. So the next layer would be here. And the cycle continues. This part here is a little bit more complex. So I'm gonna get this ready just like the one down there. All right, so we have the last cell here. This is seven in this direction and eight along here. This will be the start of the waterfall. I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through this. So each of these pistons, there should be eight total here, are going to have Repeater going into them. Just as is. And a little block of gravel. I actually had to like put the mouse over it to figure out what it was. This goes behind, and it's gonna get a couple of them. But see, this is what happens. You see, this is what happens. Oh, I was gonna take that out to move it. No. So let's see. Redstone travels 15, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yeah, about bad there. So if I take this out, okay, good. It stays. That should power all of them. Awesome. Perfect. 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 So there's going to need to be a spot in here that holds the water. And it's going to be in there. But there's air below it, so got to take care of that. And just to make it look nice and stable structurally, that's the only reason for these. It's pretty much good. So now if you take away this, wait, no it's not. There's no water in there. I'm gonna need to bring a signal over there. Okay, hold on. You gotta wait for me for a second. There. Sometimes I gesticulate just off into the air, but no, not this time. It's not one of those times. Alright, I have to get a signal there. So I can power this. And in order to do that, I gotta count these off. Every 15, usually 14 just to make sure, I put a repeater. I think, since there's a little bit of a thing here, I'll do that. If we wrap this around, and it's just gonna mostly in this direction, so every time I have a repeater, it's gotta face that way. Just along this. Bring this out all the way. I want to run a signal just into this. I think that's all I need. I have a lever here. And if I put it here. Oh, it needs to climb one. All right. That feeds into this. That's connected to those the things. So I'll finish this. How about that? I'm going to finish this, let it grow, and we can have a test run. Test run this bad boy. All right, I think we're ready. I put this here so that you can walk up it. Before, you actually could not. So now, you can. All right, so this is ready. I also put in a little bit of that, a little nether wart. So it's growing everything it could possibly grow. Those are in. So we just need to, you know, trigger it. See what happens. Now, I think it's just far away that I can't see the water. Oh, wait, there it is. All right, yeah, it's... Oh, yeah. Oh, look at it all. It's going to take a little while for it to register way up there, but it should all be coming down. Oh, see, there it goes. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. I don't think we're going to have to worry about food ever again. It's awesome to think just how far we've come, though. I remember our first farm. Do you? Yeah, me neither. Woo-wee! Oh my, yeah. Land ho! Oh! Back when I was getting cactus that one time, I remember that there was a jungle right next to it. And I also remembered that for the next project in this episode, I need to have some brown coloring. I need some brown, you know. And what I think that cocoa beans, the only place to go to get it. So I think I see a couple even way over there. Just get it and run. Ooh, there's three of them came out of that. You know, I can't just take one, though, you know. So... Get that. Oh, you're not ready, but I'm taking you anyway. But while I'm here, might as well get some resources I couldn't get otherwise. Ferns are kind of exotic. Vines. Gotta get the vines. And let's get some jungle wood. So how about chopping down this tree? So let's see. Gotta get a good stance. Here's a good one. Let's chop it down from here. Couple swing. Wait a minute. Aren't trees supposed to fall down? How confusing would this be, by the way, if this happened in real life? Like, oh yes, dunk. Wait a minute. The final touch would be to get some saplings. Yes. You know what? Can I grab one of these? I can. Okay. Nothing spruces up a place quite like a dead bush. So I'll just let me get a few of them. Let's see. Ooh. Oh, hey, got to check that out. Let's see. Ooh. Ooh, very nice. Look at that. Oh. Yeah, this is pretty normal so far. Nothing crazy. That's kind of crazy, but we got a few of those. All right. All right. I'm out of here. Don't gonna worry. Don't even gonna worry. Oh, you jerks. You jerks. Just for existing. What is this? An enchanted sword? Where did you get the idea to enchant a sword? I saw a creeper. I'll clear a spot and put a little space in between because we need those leaves. What do I not care about? I love being in the sky for this exact purpose. Get out of here! Oh, that was on camera. So we're back here. Back at the villager village. The one without villagers, if you remember. And it's gonna be the first time that I do some interior design. Now, this is where I am very lacking. So, I'm going to start small and I'm going to learn. I'm going to learn through this series how to make interior designs. So, I've got some essentials here, such as beds, whatnots. I've kind of planned out what each of these houses, they're going to be similar. They're all going to have the same things in them, but since the houses are shaped differently, the layout's going to be different. So, we start with this one. And as we step in, all right. Okay, let's start by starting. So we have rooms designated. There's a living area, bedroom, and bathroom. So start with the essentials here. Beds. It's important. I kind of like the concept of having little stands to put things. And also, I've got a few flower pots. Let's see, one of those. And each house's bedroom is gonna have a little chest. I think I like having a picture just over the bed. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful. Actually, I think this is supposed to be a little bookshelf. I think that's how I was doing it. So, no, that's pretty modest. Needs some sort of light for each room, so I'll probably just do that for now. Going to the bathroom, I'm going to make the sink with the hopper. Got a rail here. All right, see, hopefully, it gets some inspiration. There we go. And if put a cart on it, it kind of looks like a toilet. The only problem is if I go over here, it kind of shoves off. So that's not, no. Get back in there. Oh, yep, yeah, there it goes. So what I found works is put a little carpet in front of it, and there we go. It doesn't do anything. Let's see. Spruce stairs. Put one facing that way. And this way. That's the best I can do for a bathtub. Like, literally. Any other material would look weird, especially since some of these walls are parts of other rooms. I can't replace them. Like, I tried this with stone, cobblestone stairs, but really it didn't look good. So, put a torch there. I think I did that. Some kind of a sink. All right, so moving on. Moving on. A little table set up with, I think there were two chairs. And this is why I got the brown rug. Just, a little something something right there. And let's see that in the corner. I think a cauldron there, stove. Think I put upside down steps here with not just one, two trapdoors. That kind of starts to look like a thing. And I put this on top just because it looks a little different. And nice little picture. Oh yeah, running here really fast. I don't know, I like topping it off with something. Just it looks a little better, I think. I forgot to put the trash can there. So the flower pot's the trash can. And go ahead and put one there. So that, every place has one. And I guess if I ever fill this up with water, that's about it. Go ahead and put doors for the bedrooms. Bedroom bath. And I am satisfied because if you look inside, you're like, oh, cool. Cool. And if I creep a peek, cool. When I come back, all of them will be done. And then we get to move on to an even nexter step. It's hard to really describe. I don't know. Like there's something happened while I was putting in the interiors. And it's something I didn't expect. I almost felt like a strange, I don't want to say nostalgia, but like all of a sudden I just felt like, wow, this place felt more like a real place. Like before these were just empty buildings without any interiors, and like I didn't really think much of it, but now as I walk through here, I just like you can look in the windows and you could see, oh, there's actually stuff going on inside of these places. And like each one's a little bit different because I had to make the layouts kind of fit with each building, but I didn't expect to I left some of these doors open. I didn't expect there to be that profound of an impact. Like, for some reason, I don't know, the word I seem to that seems to come to mind is like warm or like kind of like if it was winter time and you knew like a house had a cozy fire inside versus like just there's none of that at all, the abandoned house. Like, I almost get that vibe from these, like even if it was unconscious before or subconscious, like I don't know, I guess I didn't put that much stock in interior design, but like if it makes this big of a difference, like for me at least, it almost feels like these are homes now. Like I actually feel myself oddly attached to this town all of a sudden. Like it's really hard to describe. I feel weird, guys. Oh. I did notice something though. Doors tend to only like to be placed on one side, and if you have like these sort of cupboard type things here, you can actually get like stuck on either those edges when going into houses, and that's kind of annoying. But I kind of remembered that doors, they're kind of funny. Like, they like to make the double door thing. Double door. And if you do that, then all of a sudden things are cool. It's fantastic. So I thought that was worth sharing. I'm pretty excited though. This is kind of the last step before I wanted to actually put like actual villagers in here. So I think that's gonna actually happen. Although I did hit a bit of a snag. I didn't realize that this place, if you're gonna put villagers in a place, you really gotta make sure that there's no way that zombies are gonna get to them. Like, they're just like, they're at each other's throats, literally. In the most literal sense. Or at least one of them's at the other's throat. And I didn't realize that there's still places that are not zombie proof or mob spawnable proof. Like, I was just walking around over there and I heard a zombie sound. And I was like, that sounds a little closer than than beyond the wall. And then it just like fell, a zombie fell right next to me and it scared me quite a bit. And like, it's like, all right. I looked up in the trees and realized that there's totally spots where things can spawn. Like, even over here, there's a too high gap right there. Something could totally spawn there and just ruin everybody's day. You can come out of the tree and be like, ha-ha! Then everyone's like, a nightmare comes to life. You know, this supposedly peaceful town. And they're like, oh God, no! Oh! You know, so I want to prefer, I mean, I want to prefer that. I want to prevent that. So it turns out that it's going to be a little bit, both making sure that all these, like, trees, for instance, aren't going to spawn anything, and getting the villagers here in the first place, it's going to be a bit of a project. So I actually don't think I'm going to be able to do it in this episode. In fact, I won't be able to do it in this episode. So that'll have to wait until next time. But I do, I am pretty happy with what was accomplished here on this day. On this day! Because I feel like as every once in a while I get like a creative streak and you just like can do way more than you usually can. And I've had that kind of happen recently. Probably because I got sick. And like when you're sick, life becomes strange. It's like more precious. And then when you're actually healthy again, you're like, all right, I'm gonna do all the things I should be doing with my life. And I guess for me, that's Minecraft. And I think I'm okay with that. Because if I'm all of a sudden really liking this place because of the extra effort I put into it, it's kind of exhilarating. I'm happy with that. So I'll return a back of next time with another episode. But until then, this has been Red McNed with the Saga. I'll see you next time.